about ulcer. So when you talk about ulcer, one of the herbs that will help you is guava, guayabano, avocado leaves. They're good for you, and also licorice. So if you're familiar with licorice, licorice can help.
Multiple ulcers in the, I assume this is in the stomach, okay? So cabbage juice, that's good for you. Cabbage juice, aloe vera, guayabano, and for me, pixie dust, yes.
Cabbage. Actually, cabbage juice is good for peptic ulcers. And also aloe vera.
Guava leaves and kymeta leaves. Guava leaves, if you use it, 95% of acute gastroenteritis will be gone just by using guava leaves. 95%, that's too high.
So when you talk about GERD, which is one of the most common problems of the people right now, meron kasi tayong mga sphincter sa katawan natin. So you have a sphincter from your lower esophageal sphincter. The one that is from the esophagus at saka yung stomach mo. So, hindi siya masyado nagsasarado yung sphincter doon. So, pag kumakain tayo, dapat sarado yon. Pag hindi sarado yon, so yung acid, minsan umaakyat dito sa dibdib natin. So, masakit yung dibdib natin. So, what you usually do is, this occurs when patients are very fat.
GERD, pixie dust magnesium, and you can also use cabbage juice, aloe vera, guayabano leaves. Madami po yan. So you can just choose. Pwede din po yung guava, kaimito leaves. Yan, nakakatulong din po yan sa GERD na tinatawag. Now, pag may GERD ka, ang magiging problema mo lang dyan, you increase your incidence of developing esophageal cancer. Kasi yung acid umaakyat sa sa esophagus mo. So, one of the problem there is that you can develop cancer in the future. So, you have to take care of GERD. I have a bad GERD.
You have a bad little boy right now. Mm.
Or when my dad was alive, oh my God, he would...
he was awful.
It was awful, right? Yeah. It was, I think... we went to Manila.
Best father-in-law I could hope for.
Burp siya ng burp.
Worst patient ever.
I think he was burping like every single minute. Yeah, because of the GERD. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And one that can really help you with me, with my bad GERD, the one that really helped me is pixie dust magnesium. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it helped me a lot. Oh, I cannot offer...
Big time.
Yeah, because I'm not burping anymore.
Nope.
Especially when I came back here. When I came here in the U.S., when I came back to the U.S. and here as well. So my GERD was just so awful because I didn't release my pixie dust magnesium yet. So it was just awful. But then when I started drinking it again, when it was available, it really helped me. Gastric cancer. So for gastric cancer, you can take guayabano leaves, avocado leaves, cabbage, okay? And Boston Sea as well, and pixie dust.
Okay, they're asking if the sour is bad for people who have problems in the stomach. Okay, no, not really. It depends on someone. Like vitamin C, diba? They kept asking, like, especially ascorbic acid is bad for people who have duodenal ulcer or gastric ulcer. Apparently,
that's not
it's
what the science says.
For...
That's not what the science says.
Yeah.
That's been studied scientifically, and the studies have shown and demonstrated that it's good for that.
It's good for you, okay? How many percent? If I'm not mistaken, 30%,
mm-hmm.
okay, of people who are taking vitamin C is actually improved,
mm-hmm.
okay, using your vitamin C. If you have problems with your ulcers, duodenal ulcer.
Okay lang ba ang vitamin C sa hyperacidity? You know what? I just read in a book today because that's my concern as well. For ascorbic acid, they were saying, you know, it's bad for patient to have a hyperacidity. I was reading a book, I think a couple of days ago, and it was saying that vitamin C or ascorbic acid is actually good for patients who are very, very sensitive on the gastric area. Diba? O sabi nila, hindi ka daw pwede. But
it's what you've always recommended. My wife has always recommended it in very high doses, and she was able to achieve an unparalleled level of success in the treatment of incurable cancers and degenerative diseases. So